The first charges have been filed in the Mueller investigation. The charges are still sealed under orders from a federal judge. As someone who sits on the Intelligence Committee who knows this case well, I wanted to get your sense about which Trump associates you might be watching over the next couple days, who might find themselves in legal jeopardy.
Well, I can't really speculate. I don't know any more than you or your prior guests about what those indictments are going to look like, who they're going to be, how many they're going to be. I think we're just going to have to wait and see. I think it's important, Jake, to distinguish between what we're doing on the Senate Intelligence Committee and Director Mueller's investigation. Director Mueller is looking at criminal violations. That's his job. He's a federal prosecutor. In our case, we're looking at the facts. What did the Russians do? How did they do it? How did we prevent it next time? And also, was there some relationship between the Russians and the Trump campaign? They're a different kind of investigation. So we're on parallel tracks, but not the same track. So like everyone else in Washington, I'll be watching tomorrow to see what comes out of the Mueller investigation. But I think it's important to emphasize that this, whatever it is really just the beginning, and I'm sure there will be additional evidence, assuming Director Mueller uncovers additional evidence. He's going to follow the facts where they lead.
Well, you mentioned the investigation by your committee into whether or not there was any collusion between members of the Trump team and any agents of the Russian government. Have you found any evidence that there was?
Well, that's another question I'm not going to answer because we're in the middle of the investigation. I can tell you that our staff and our members have interviewed something like 100 witnesses, hundreds of thousands of pages of documents. We're still in the middle of that, and so I'm not going to comment on where we are. What we're not in the middle of, and I think what's really being sort of lost, Jake, in all the noise about was there collusion and Mueller and all that, the Russians egregiously meddled in our democracy in 2016, and they're still doing it, and they're going to do it again, and they're set up in Spain now, and they're setting up in Scotland. They have discovered a way to turn the strengths of our country and the West against ourselves. I call it geopolitical jujitsu, where they're taking advantage of our free press and our open society and driving divisions. And there's no question that they did that in 2016 in a big way. And we're going to talk about that this week at the committee with Facebook and Twitter. And this is a really serious problem. And all the excitement about the collusion issue, which is really important, has obscured what I believe is the larger issue, which is that our country was, is, and will be under attack.
President Trump is working hard to discredit all the investigations, House, Senate, and Mueller. On Friday, he tweeted, quote, "It's now commonly agreed after many months of costly looking that there was no collusion between Russia and Trump, was collusion with Hillary Clinton." So is that accurate, that it's widely agreed, commonly agreed, that there was no collusion?
No, I don't think so. It's certainly not commonly agreed in our committee, and we're the ones that are doing the investigation. I don't think there's any basis for that statement. We may end up, it's entirely possible, we'll end up at the investigation at the end finding that there wasn't. But the contrary could also be true. Right now, as Chairman Burr said, we're not talking about winding up for some 6 months. So there's a lot of work to be done, a lot of leads to be followed, a lot of witnesses to be interviewed. And it's way premature to say that some kind of conclusion has been reached.
Some Republican lawmakers are suggesting that Bob Mueller should step down, that he has a conflict of interest. What do you think about that?
Well, I agree exactly with Governor Christie, who you spoke to just a few minutes ago, who said, number one, Bob Mueller is a guy of impeccable reputation. He's a professional prosecutor, 30 years in law enforcement, and he'll be the one that decides if there is some kind of conflict. I haven't seen it. He's, like I say, when he was appointed, everyone from Newt Gingrich all across the spectrum said, oh, this is a brilliant appointment. He'll follow the facts where they lead. And that's exactly what he's doing, is keeping his head down and assembled a strong team, and he's going to follow. And it's really important, Jake, because the public ultimately has to have confidence in the result, both of what he's doing and what we're doing. And that means you've got to turn over the leads. You've got to go to the end and say either something happened or something didn't happen, and that's got to have credibility. I don't see any reason why he should recuse himself or be fired or anything else. The fact that these charges are suddenly coming in a kind of crescendo at the very time it appears there are also indictments to be forthcoming, there is a kind of coincidence there that I don't think you can miss.
Senator, stick around. We have a lot more to talk about, including one prominent Republican who says Democrats are going to try to impeach President Trump if they win the House majority in 2008. Is that part of the Democratic plan? Stay with us. Welcome back to State of the Union. We're joined again by Senator Angus King, independent senator of Maine. He's on the Senate Intelligence Committee. Senator, the White House and its allies on Capitol Hill and in the media have been eager to refocus attention from the Mueller probe and the Senate and House Intelligence Committee probes to instead talk about questions about the actions of Bill and Hillary Clinton. One of the issues is the Obama administration approval in 2010 of the sale of a majority stake in a Canadian uranium mining company to a Russian company. Take a listen to what President Trump had to say about this week.
I think the uranium sale to Russia and the way it was done, so underhanded, with tremendous amounts of money being passed, I actually think that's Watergate modern age.
Senator King, what's your response, and do you think Congress should investigate the deal or the FBI informant whose lawyer says he has information about Russian efforts to influence the Clintons to win support for the deal?
Well, I think the House, one of the House committees has already begun an oversight committee hearing. I always think oversight hearings are appropriate. I've been trying to understand this deal. I think the important thing that I learned in reading the background is the company changed hands, but the uranium that's mined in the United States cannot leave the United States. So it wasn't really the sale of uranium, it was the sale of a mining and manufacturing company. But there are questions about it, and I think we need to get to the bottom of them. I don't think that there's, you have to try to find out the facts if there are questions raised. And I think, as I say, the House has already got something underway on that question. Hopefully we can get it resolved and keep moving forward.
We also learned this week that a lawyer for the Clinton campaign and the DNC at least partially funded that opposition research dossier into then-candidate Trump. John Podesta and Congresswoman Debbie Wasserman Schultz, who was the head of the DNC at the time, they both say they had no idea that they were funding the dossier looking into President Trump's connections to Russia. Do you believe them?
Well, what I've been hearing for months, and not in just in the last few days, is that this thing was originally opposition research begun by Republicans during the primary period, and I think that's been confirmed in the last few days. And then after the primaries were over, in effect, the opposition research was turned over to the Democrats. And, you know, I don't know who funded it or how it was funded, but it wasn't a surprise to me because that was what I understood had happened. And as Governor Christie said, unfortunately, in this day and age, opposition research is part of the political process, and it goes on, all the time amongst both parties. And in fact, in this case, it was an opposition research product that was partially funded by the Republicans at the beginning and then at the end was funded by the Democrats.
Ohio Senator Sherrod Brown is urging his fellow Democrats to work with President Trump on a plan to cut taxes for working families. You're on the Senate Budget Committee. Where do you come down on the issue? Do you think a deal is possible with President Trump on the tax issue?
Well, I think a deal is possible. One of the odd things about the process that we're undertaking now is it's just like health care. It's all being done entirely behind closed doors by Republicans, only by Republicans. I can tell you, I'm not a Democrat. I'm an independent, but I do meet with the Democrats. And there's a majority of the Democratic caucus that wants to do tax cuts. It's just a question of how are they funded, how are they directed, who will get the benefits. So I think there is a deal there. And hopefully that's the direction we'll go in instead of trying to jam down some massive unfunded tax cut that will only add to our kids' deficits.
Your colleague, Senator Lindsey Graham, a Republican from South Carolina, said on Friday that if the Republican Party doesn't pass tax reform, Democrats will win back the House and then they will attempt to impeach President Trump. Take a listen.
Well, I think all of us realize that if we fail on taxes, that's the end of the Republican Party's governing majority in 2018. I can't imagine how he could be successful with Nancy Pelosi running the House. They'd try to impeach him pretty quick.
Is Senator Graham right about this?
again, I'm not a Democrat. I haven't heard any talk to that effect. I don't know what I don't know where that goes. I think President Trump is transactional. He likes to do deals. I mean, that's his whole career. And again, on taxes, I think there's a deal there to be had. It may not be massive and the biggest in history, but I wish we could skip this jam down phase and move to the bipartisan discussion phase. And I think we could get something done and he could claim success.
Senator Angus King, independent of Maine, thank you so much for your time. Always good to see you, sir.
Yes, sir. Thank you, Jake.